Hi, this is Open Play. I'm sorry that I spoke in the voice of a machine, not my own voice. I inform you in advance that my mother language is Korean, not English, and there is a grammatical error in my remarks. I uploaded Playmaker tutorial videos until last year, but since July, I haven't even uploaded even one. The reason is that I stopped using Playmaker and made games using C Sharp. So many challenges were needed during the transition from Playmaker to C Sharp. Not only has it changed from visual and node type to unfamiliar text-based scripting, but it has also changed how game logic is implemented. But while I was working with C Sharp, I found more advantages than when I was working as a Playmaker. Let me tell you the details of why I moved from Playmaker to C Sharp. Collaborate with other programmers. As you know, programmers are used to text-based programming, not visual scripting. In addition, the disadvantage of node-type visual scripting is that it is difficult to see when it becomes more complex. Playmaker, Bolt, which is recently acquired by Unity, and even Unreal's Blueprint have these shortcomings. If there is a code that only I can recognize in collaboration with others, it is a huge problem. The format needs to be unified, and someone has to work with other formats. Unfortunately, the Playmaker is not a typical code format, so I boldly chose to switch to C Sharp. I thought it would take time to get used to it as much as I started anew. But I didn't have much difficulty because I knew the basic structure and principles of Unity. Managing a lot of data. No matter how simple a game is planned and created, many of you may have experienced the complexity of scripts. This reveals the biggest drawback of visual scripting. The complexity of the script means that many variables have occurred. C# scripting can create many inevitably generated variables in just a few lines. But the Playmaker needs multiple states and actions to complete, and it looks messy. The biggest drawback is that the Playmaker cannot use the list. There's an array, but you can't do things like remove elements or change the order. You have no choice but to create a complex FSM in a way similar to list. Eventually, in the middle or end of the project, it becomes harder than C# when we have to modify that part. In addition, it is a major obstacle to maintain after the game is released. Maintaining and updating. The Playmaker is late to update. That's why the latest version of Unity with Playmaker has some little problems. In my experience, I don't need to use the latest version of Unity. But I'm still unhappy with the slow update of Hutong Games, which doesn't respond quickly to the new version of Unity. The problem between the Playmaker and the Unity version will have a significant impact on not only new projects but also on the maintaining of previous projects. When you load a game that you created a long time ago into a new version of Unity, you get a lot of errors even though you updated latest version of Playmaker. If you can work with the C# script, you can solve problems easily, but if you don't, you cannot even start playing the game. In fact, one of my games, Slide Dungeons, was taken a month by updating work with new version of Unity. And it was judged that making games with C# has more advantages of maintenance than Playmaker. That doesn't mean that the Playmaker is bad. Without Playmaker, I wouldn't be here now. I was a 3D graphic artist, not a programmer or computer engineer. And I was able to make games because I used easy-to-understand tools. And I'm not forcing you to use C#. If you have made and released games with Playmaker, I'd like to let you know that you have to think about the future for better game making. Moving from Playmaker to C# requires some essential steps. Completion and release of a game with a Playmaker. Minimum of 2 or more. If you had completed and released the game through Playmaker, you would have understood the logic of making the game. You've learned how to use basic variables, how to use conditional statements, and how to make rules for the game. And with the final launch, you'll have a general understanding of how games are made. The difference between game making completion and not completion is huge. Be sure to complete the game making and launch it on the store at least too. Otherwise, there will have big pain in the work transition from Playmaker to C#. Always start small project. Regardless of the success of the game, the completion of the game production, such as the marathon, makes you proud. And you know that you're planning to implement a bigger aspiration in your next game project. But you're ultimately going to have to use C# because of the various inconveniences of the Playmaker that I told you earlier. Access to the new format must also begin with a small project. In my case, I made a quiz game based on 2D UI. Through the project, I relearned how to use classes, components, variables, and etc. Mathematics. Many people who are not majoring in computer science might think difficult about math. However, math is important in the game. For example, starting with a simple score, the amount of damage to a player or enemies, the level and experience calculations, and the displaying of HP bars should all be expressed through the mathematical formula. You need to know basic addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, as well as higher mathematics for higher level expression. However, complex calculations may not be necessary in most situations, depends on your game project. If you are not familiar with mathematics, I recommend you to master at least the level you have learned in middle school. That's all for today's video, and next we'll look at the basic of C# scripting. Thank you and see you next time.